What's up, everyone? It's Dominic here for Obligatory, bringing you an overview of the new music that dropped within the past week for the week ending Friday, May 12th. This week is kind of one of the lighter weeks in terms of new music this year, so we're going to run through a couple of the albums released this past week a bit quicker than normal, starting with NBA YoungBoy's new mixtape, Richest Op, which is already his third project of the year so far. NBA YoungBoy is already a well-established enough artist that you probably know where you stand prior to listening to this. YoungBoy fan, great week for you, but if he's yet to impress you, chances are this one won't be the one to make you switch sides or change your opinion. Completely different stylistically, we have another one that probably isn't going to change your mind on this artist, as the Jonas Brothers have put out a new album simply titled The Album. It is also with this album that I discovered that, at least according to Wikipedia, because I cannot find the album's credits anywhere else, that the brothers themselves only contributed vocals to the album. Shouldn't be too surprised, I guess, but it also makes me feel like I was kind of being lied to all those times I saw them on Disney Channel as a kid. Rapper Chavo and producer Pierre Bourne link up for the third time on Chavo's World 3, which is actually the fourth project they've done together, with Mixed Emotions being the title of their first. This is another slice of modern cloud slash pop trap from the two. A quick run through, we've also got some new projects from Soulja Boy, Hot Mulligan, Deontay Hitchcock, and Kiki Palmer. Worth noting that this is already the second release by a former Disney star or stars that we've mentioned in this video. We're going to skip over a few, but you can see the full list of albums that we put together on your screen if you want to pause and read that list. But otherwise, let's jump into some albums that we really want to highlight from this week. With the first of a couple slacker rock and slowcore adjacent releases that I'm going to mention, we have Antarctica, the new album from Connecticut band Waveform. It's dreamy, it's spacey, it's melancholic, and it's out now via Run for Cover Records. Jumping from Connecticut across the Atlantic over to London, we have the self-titled debut album from Island of Love, who are actually the first band signed to Third Man Records London. Island of Love's sound is somewhat indebted to a lot of the noisier indie rock of the 90s a la Dinosaur Jr., but with the band's roots in hardcore punk and their ability to meld primal noise and some really strong melodies make this more than just a nostalgia piece. Let's travel again to another continent, because if you're not paying attention to the garage punk scene in Melbourne, and all of Australia for that matter, it's not too late. There are so many great bands coming out of Australia that we could, and just might, do a future video on it, and Dragnet is one of the newest that should be on your radar. The Accession is raw but refined, punchy post-punk with a silly youthful energy behind it all. It's out now via Spoilsport Records. New York rapper and pro-era member Chuck Strangers just put out a new EP titled The Boys and Girls. At 10 tracks, it's bordering on album territory, but it only runs just over 21 minutes, and hey, if the artist says it's an EP, then that's what it is. Boys and Girls sports features from rappers Navy Blue, Fly Anakin, Pink Sifu, and more. In 2021, the legendary French electronic duo Daft Punk called it quits, and we just got what the duo has referred to as their last song ever with the release of a 10th anniversary edition of Random Access Memories. This edition features some outtakes, demos, and previously unreleased songs from the 2013 sessions, including the last song ever that features Julian Casablancas and The Voids on a smooth, soulful track that seems to be the last we'll hear of Daft Punk. In a similar vein, we've also got a remastered edition of Animal Collective's debut album, Spirit They're Gone, Spirit They've Vanished, which features 5 previously unreleased tracks in addition to the remastered album. Moving on to the singles portion of the video, you can pause if you want to read the full list that we've put together. Otherwise, we're going to go ahead and highlight some of the biggest names to drop within the past week, as well as some of our personal favorites. Billie Eilish just dropped the track Hotline Edit, which is a 1-minute ukulele-based cover of Drake's Hotline Bling. Eilish originally covered the track in 2018, uploading it to SoundCloud. This version is half the length of her original cover and only features her take on the hook, but it is the first time that it has been available on all platforms. Lil Durk teams up with J. Cole for the sentimental single All My Life, which is the first single from Lil Durk's new album, Almost Healed, which is set to release May 26th. English singer-songwriter Georgia Smith just released the track Little Things, which is the second release on her own label, FAM, following her previous single Try Me. This one is a funky UK garage-inspired track about romantic connections and what those mean. Queens of the Stone Age just dropped a new sort of glam rock-inspired track titled Emotion Sickness. The band also just announced their first album in 6 years, titled In Time's New Roman, which is set to be released June 16th via Matador Records. Arlo Parks teams up with Phoebe Bridgers for a new single with the track Pegasus. In Parks' own words, this love ballad is about, quote, experiencing the warmth and lightness of good love for the first time. Pegasus is the third single from Arlo Parks' upcoming album, My Soft Machine, which will be out May 26th on Transgressive Records. Following up on 2018's Dirty Computer, Janelle Monáe just announced their new album with the release of lead single and reggae pop track Lipstick Lover. Their new album, The Age of Pleasure, will be out June 9th via Monáe's own Wonderland Art Society in conjunction with Atlantic Records. Alt-pop, indie rock, hip-hop, and just overall genre-bending artist Gene Dawson just released two new singles as the first installment of a trilogy that sees him adopting an alter ego of sorts named Phoenix. These two tracks in particular steer toward the direction of post-punk and gothic rock, with a little bit of dream pop thrown in for good measure, introducing Phoenix as a bit of a darker character than we've known Dawson to be, but it is impossible to predict if this will stay true for further installments. Experimental hip-hop duo Paris, Texas just dropped a new track with a rap rock feel to it titled Bullet Man. Along with its accompanying music video, it is a really fascinating release that is jam-packed with this sort of boastful and infectious energy, but also some darker implications as they relate to looming gun violence in America. Los Angeles-based rapper and 2022 XXL freshman KC has a new single out now called Roll the Dice, produced by French producer Gesaffelstein. This track falls somewhere between alternative R&B and synthpop. Louisville, Kentucky-based trio Wombo just shared the track Slab and announced an EP of the same name, which is set to release June 9th via Fire Talk Records. Slab is Wombo at their best, balancing frenetic and angular guitar work with a certain level of mystique that's really brought out by a deadpan and almost indifferent vocal delivery. Pittsburgh's Feeble Little Horse have a new single out titled Pocket, which is off of their upcoming album Girl with Fish, which is also set to be released on June 9th, this time via Saddle Creek Records. Pocket is a little less noisier than the usual shoegazy sort of pop we hear from the band, mostly being a very catchy and super playful indie pop track until the end, where it gets a little bit noisier. Drew Collins and friends, better known as Sundots, just released the tracks Green and Foot Hockey. Green is the first single from the upcoming album Honeyspot, which should be out sometime this year but has no official release date yet. Green, like much of Sundot's work to this point, finds an interesting medium between indie folk and slowcore. In what is likely the last single from their upcoming album, Everyone's Crushed, which is set to release May 26th via Matador Records, Brooklyn duo Water From Your Eyes share the track 14. This one, while just as great, comes in contrast to the previous two singles, which had driving post-punk rhythms and heavy influences from the no-wave movement. 14, however, is much gentler with a chamber folk sort of ambient pop feel to it, and is easily the most somber and emotional of the bunch. The pairing of Kate Envy and Angel Deridorian as Decisive Pink continue to impress with their fourth single of the year. Their latest single, titled Dopamine, is art funk meets minimal synth for a deadpan look at consumerism and the cycles it creates. It is just the right amount of weirdness to make you even more excited for June 9th, which is when their debut album, Ticket to Fame, is set to be released through Fire Records. Continuing on a bit of a similar theme, San Francisco's Spiritual Cramp have a new single out called Phone Lines Down, which is 2 minutes of pure garage punk rock energy about pulling out your phone whenever you're bored or need a distraction, which is usually never because all the distractions you'd ever need in the world are always right by your side. Ending the video with some more shoegaze slash slowcore, we have a new track from New Jersey slash New York duo Joyer. If you love yourself some lo-fi fuzzy rock, this one's for you. And if it is, that's great. If not, hopefully something else this week caught your eye. We are currently polling for albums by Larry June and The Alchemist, Chance the Rapper, New Order, Beach House, and Playboi Carti. If any of those artists are of any interest to you, whether you love them, hate them, or anywhere in between, make sure you check out our voting form where you can submit a score, select top tracks, and submit a review for a chance to be featured. And lastly, if you haven't done this already, go check out our previous video where Dev covered some news stories and music that happened over the past week or so, and thank you so much for watching.